when your clip is ready to render, you go to File, click Render, and then you get the export options. And then you get a couple of several different options. You can render it out as an MP4 movie or as an MP4 that's rendered using NVIDIA's GPU processing. The Mistika format is their own proprietary format. You can read more about it, but it essentially gives you some pretty high-end post-production rendering codecs to use. Also, ProRes or image sequences are available. We traditionally pretty much use ProRes for most of our work. ProRes just regular ProRes 422 is pretty good for most of our options. Because we are not doing a stereoscopic image render, you would want to set it to no stereo. But if you are doing stereoscopic, you want to make sure that you click the correct stereo format. Otherwise, it will not render out correctly. But we'll do that for that. For this one, we can the default for audio is to not render out audio. The other option is to render out the audio as a separate file, or you can render it out as a movie, like inside the movie container, if the file type that you chose allows for embedded audio. So for example, if you did an image sequence, you can't put audio inside the movie because that's not a format that accepts it. And then you have the destination. So this is the name of the file. So we can choose a spot on our desktop. We can just say stitch B1, for example. And then there are some options to include automatically in the media name, the name of the folder. The render name is this name here. You can also have it include the source name. If I click that button, it would include the name of the clip. So those are helpful things. And then if you just want to render out one clip, and usually it's the one that's highlighted or the one that's highlighted white, that'll be the current shot. But if you had a bunch of clips, you can also batch process everything by doing all shots. And then for that, you would be helpful to click the segment index. And then it basically would put a number one at the very end of the file name for the first clip, a two at the end of the file name for the second clip, and so on. But because we just have one clip, we will just go back to current and then I click render. And you'll see it render the audio real quick, and then it rendered out the video. And if we go to our desktop, I can open up this piece of footage. Nope, sorry, this is encoded in ProRes, which is not supported by the default Windows player. But here is the basic stitch that we created. And that is the basics of using Mistika VR. I hope you're enjoying this preview of my cinematic 360 video post-production class. You can get this tutorial and 5 complete chapters for free by signing up at learn.voyer.com. The full class includes 10 hours of content covering stereoscopic, 360 video, 180 VR, and more. It's now available at learn.voyer.com, so go ahead and check it out.